Nityanandam, Swamiji's narration on what happened after he received the saffron robe. Maybe after some time, their attention turned to me. One person said, "Who is this person? He is the only person without kavi, saffron robe here. Who is not a swami, not a sannyasi?" When I heard what he said, immediately my kundalini stood up. I said, "I am not wearing kavi, but I am also sannyasi only." And I saw Arunagiri Yogeshwara laugh. Then he asked, why are you not wearing kavi?" I told him, you give me kavi." He laughed. He looked towards somebody. Immediately I saw one sadhu bring kavi cloth. I did not even have a second thought to remove and throw the dress. I just removed my entire dress naked. I walked near him without having a second thought, and he himself tied the kavi cloth around me waist like a dhoti. He himself tied it, and I still remember he just tied the cloth and hugged me. He gave me energy darshan by putting his hand on my head. Naturally, the experience was just out of the world, and I came and sat in the group. Now I felt one with the group, and the group also felt one with me. They did not feel that then that I was an outsider. One good thing, I still have the cloth given by him. Because the cloth is there, I feel that experience has either happened in the physical plane or metaphysical plane, which can get converted to physical plane. There are some metaphysical experience which disappear when the conversation into the physical plane happens. But there was some solid metaphysical experience that becomes physical when they come down to physical plane. Sri Ramakrishna once had experience of Lord Rama giving him a pot full of porridge, a mud pot full of porridge. When he came down from that experience, he had the pot in his hand. The pot was there. It did not disappear. Only Rama from form disappeared. So I can say that this experience was in the metaphysical plane, but the item given remained when it settled down into the physical plane. That is why I feel the experience has become a physical bio memory in me. It remains in a physical bio energy. He takes me back to the temple. I regain my body consciousness. Once it became little dark, late in the evening, he said, "Come on, let's go back to the temple." I said, "Okay." He brought me back. When we entered the cave again, he was holding my hand. When we came out of the cave to the exact place where we entered, only there he left my hand. Only when he left my hand, I came to the physical awareness. All these references to the banyan tree under which your young guru taught older disciple as Arunagiri Yogeshwara or Dakshinamurti are to Shambhala, the abode of the Saptarishi, seven sages, the cosmic energy center. You can reach Shambhala from Tapovan, which is over 15,000 feet high in Himalayas beyond Gangodri and Gomukh. With the Guru's help, you can reach Shambhala from anywhere. Guru can act as an air strip to take you to the space at any time. Banyan tree that Ramana Maharshi refers to and banyan tree to the Bedari are like air strip or helipads. These are the location to take off and reach the spiritual planes where Arunagiri Yogeshwara resides in pure consciousness as Dakshinamurti Sadashiva himself. Such beautiful story Swamiji narrates about how he received his first kavi. Thank you, Nityananda.